Muy buenas noches. Ya, mis queridos hermanos, dentro de prontito vamos a dar inicio a la ceremonia de graduación virtual de la Escuela San Adalberto. Vayan enviando los enlaces a sus amigos y familiares para que nadie se pierda nada de esta hermosa celebración. En alrededor de unos 3-4 minutos, quizás 2 minutos, estamos comenzando. Ustedes vayan repartiendo ese enlace por todos lados para que sean muchos los que vengan a acompañar a nuestros hermosos jóvenes en este día tan especial para ellos.
Good evening, everyone, and welcome to our live stream for the Class of 2020 graduation ceremony for St. Adalbert School. We will begin our broadcast in about 2 minutes, so please share this link with everyone that you know so that we can get as many people watching as possible so they can enjoy this beautiful ceremony that we have put together for our lovely Class of 2020. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to our live stream for the Class of 2020 graduation ceremony for St. Adalbert School. We will begin our broadcast of the graduation ceremony in about 1 minute, so please share this link with everyone that you know so that we can get as many people watching. We will begin the graduation ceremony in 1 minute.
Good evening, everybody, and welcome to the Class of 2020 St. Adalbert School graduation. We are very blessed to have you participate with us this evening.
Buenas tardes a todos, y bienvenidos sean a la graduación del año 2020 de la Escuela San Adalberto. Nos sentimos bendecidos de que cada uno de ustedes celebre con nosotros en esta oportunidad.
This evening is a celebration of our graduates. A celebration of their overcoming challenges and persevering through obstacles this year in order to graduate and move on to high school and beyond.
Esta es una celebración principalmente para nuestros estudiantes, los graduandos de este día. Nos alegramos con ellos porque a pesar de cada obstáculo, a pesar de todas las extremas circunstancias, aquí están y como familias celebramos juntos.
We are very grateful to our staff and faculty and our film crew for providing an experience for our students that would be unique, but also deserving of their efforts this year.
Nos sentimos ciertamente orgullosos y agradecidos con todo nuestro equipo de trabajo, todo el staff de la escuela, que ha hecho posible que este sueño de cada uno de nuestros estudiantes se haga realidad.
While our video will seem very seamless, all of our videos were taken at different times to ensure the safety of our families, our graduates, and our staff in order to have a virtual ceremony, meeting the guidelines of the CDC and the Archdiocese of Milwaukee.
Ciertamente cumpliendo con todos los reglamentos del CDC y de la Arquidiócesis de Milwaukee, llevamos a cabo esta realización de la graduación a través de un video virtual. A pesar de que todos ustedes van a poder notar que ciertamente la participación pareciera que fuera continua, pero tuvimos que tomar todas las medidas, todas las precauciones para asegurar que tanto nuestros estudiantes como sus familiares y nuestro equipo de trabajo se encontraban bajo medidas de seguridad.
We hope you enjoy the ceremony. We know you are as proud of our graduates as we are. So thank you for joining us. God bless you and enjoy the ceremony.
Les invitamos a participar de esta celebración. Gracias por acompañarnos. Vamos a celebrar juntos. Vamos a orar juntos. Vamos a acompañar a estos nuestros hijos. Que lo disfruten. Hoy es un día de alegría. Hoy es un día de fiesta. Hoy es un día para dar gracias a Dios. Y nosotros como comunidad nos reunimos para celebrarles a ustedes, mis queridos hijos, graduandos, como también para poder celebrar a sus familias. Oramos por nuestras intenciones y por las intenciones del mundo entero. En estos momentos, I'm going to ask everybody to please stand. And let us begin with this opening prayer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Good and loving God, we thank you for the completion of another academic year and for giving us the opportunity. Sure though, under these circumstances, it may have been to play a part in the lives of our students and our new graduates. We are grateful for your guidance and love as we share in this important work. Te damos gracias, Señor, por este día y por ayudarnos a culminar este año académico. Aunque ha parecido corto en medio de unas circunstancias externas, aquí estamos. Aquí estamos para darte gracias. Gracias por darnos tu generosidad, tu compasión. Gracias por siempre mostrarnos tu amor de Padre. Please bless and guide our graduates as they reach this end, and as they share new beginnings. May what they have learned by being here with us allow them to truly be women and men for others. May what they have learned from them enable us to be the same. Te pedimos, Señor, que estos jovencitos que se enfrentan a este nuevo mundo verdaderamente puedan hacer fructíferos en tu gracia con todo lo que han podido aprender y todo lo que han podido vivir junto a nosotros. Y haz que la huella que también ellos han dejado en nosotros también las podamos mostrar a otras personas. Please help them to use all they have learned here to make the world a better place, to serve others in true solidarity and kindship, to seek ways to help the poor, the marginalized, and those who are suffering, and to always seek the greater good. Ayúdalos, Señor, a no ser indiferentes ante las necesidades del otro. We know that some of them will experience pain and hardship, and we know that some of them already have, and we ask you to grant them solace and strength. En cada una de sus oportunidades más duras, Señor, bendíceles y acompáñeles. Father, we thank you for giving us the opportunity to build our community with these, our children, and our students while they are here. Though they are leaving our campus, we know that they will always be with us as a part of St. Adalbert School family. And we ask that the bonds that have been created here remain strong despite any distance. Te pedimos, Señor, que verdaderamente siempre nos recuerdes con amor estas caras, estos talentos, estos tesoros, que siempre formarán parte de nuestra comunidad, de la comunidad, de la familia, de la escuela San Adalberto. Todo esto te lo pedimos por Jesucristo, nuestro Señor. Amén. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Congratulations, muchachos. Mis felicidades a todos los papás. Muchas, muchas felicidades y abundantes gracias para todos.
Welcome to the class of 2020 virtual graduation service. As we celebrate the eighth graders transitioning into high school, let's pray together they will continue to be great examples of Jesus. Let our graduates remember to let Christ shine in their lives and to lead others to Jesus. May the graduates remember what Jesus said in Matthew chapter 28, verses 18 through 20. All authority in heaven and on earth has been given to me. Go therefore and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all that I have commanded you, and behold, I am with you always to the end of the age. As we celebrate today, let us remember to use our remarkable gifts and talents to always do God's work. And remember, anything is possible with God. Thank you for joining us for this celebration.
A lectura de Proverbios capítulo 2, verso 1 al 10. Hijo mío, si recibes mis palabras y atesoras mis mandamientos dentro de ti, haciendo su odio a la sabiduría, e inclinando su corazón a la prudencia. Si llamas a la inteligencia y alzas tu voz, si la buscas como a la plata y la procuras como un tesoro, entonces entenderás el temor del Señor y hallarás el conocimiento de Dios, porque el Señor da la sabiduría, de su boca conocimiento y la inteligencia. Él provee la sana sabiduría a los rectos, es como un escudo a los que caminan rectamente. Guarda las sendas de la justicia y velar por el camino de sus santos. Entonces entenderás justicia, juicio y equidad, y todo será un buen camino. Cuando la sabiduría entre en tu corazón y el conocimiento se grato a tu alma, la palabra de Dios.
This poem is a collection of our most fondest memories here at St. Adalbert. We have been through a lot together, and we wanted to take a few minutes to remember some of our most important moments.
Este poema es una colección de nuestros mejores recuerdos en San Alberto. Hemos pasado por muchas cosas juntos y queremos tomarnos unos momentitos para recordar algunas de nuestras memorias más importantes.
My first day of 4K, seeing my teachers and friends on the first day of school, when I received my first communion in second grade, walking to the park as a school for field day, all the times we laughed and bonded together as a class.
Field trips like Discovery World, roller skating at Marquette University, when we were able to make blankets for those in need, when Ms. Smith said that 8S was her favorite class. For sure, when Ms. Renteria would scare us in the LA class, but we denied being scared.
When we went bowling and had fun competing with our friends, playing Minute to Win It games during the Catholic school week, building gingerbread houses before winter break, when Ms. Ramirez told us that she can engage, when we won the soccer tournament 2 years in a row.
Reading at Mass for the first time, when I got my first report card and saw that I had straight A's, when we went to Marquette University for a field trip, the times we were able to wear our hoodies in class, learning with my friends who feel like a second family.
Celebrating Mexican Independence Day for the first time with Mr. Heading, when the entire cafeteria sang to me on my birthday, the time we got stuck in the classroom and got ice cream sandwiches afterwards, having blue and gold days, and finally planning for graduation and thinking of all the great memories I have at this school.
It is my pleasure to introduce our staff graduation speaker, Ms. Smith. Students had the chance to vote and nominate Ms. Smith as our graduation speaker. She is our math teacher as well as the grade level chair of the middle school teachers. She has been a teacher at St. Adalbert School for 2 years. We have learned so much from her and could have not made it this year without her.
Welcome, graduates, family, friends, teachers, and staff. What a year this has been. When I was asked to give the staff speech this year, I thought because I know these students so well, I would sit down and everything would just come easily to me. Little did I know, I have so many wonderful things to say about these students, I don't know where to begin. Sitting next to you now or watching from the comfort of their own home are the people who have been there to love and support you through your time here at St. Adalbert. You have made them so proud. They have encouraged you to join a club or sport, they celebrated your trimester grades, and they were even there to push you to go to school when 7 o'clock was just too early to get up. This is a day they have been looking forward to since they dropped you off at your very first day of K-4. As much as this day is for you, it is also for them. Their babies are growing up. Give them a big hug and thank them. Thank them for being there when you made mistakes and giving you just enough tough love to succeed. You have all grown so much since the beginning of the year. I think about March 13th a lot. We finished our math projects and celebrated Pi Day by eating cookies and pie and playing cool math games. We didn't know that would be it. I remember at the end of that last day when we were doing Stations of the Cross in our classroom. You all read and participated like the mature 14-year-olds you had grown to be. I thought to myself, we finally did it. We were finally over that transitional time where you had the responsibility of being 8th graders, but still had a little bit of that 7th grade mindset. I thought the rest of the year would be smooth sailing from there. If there's one thing our time apart has taught us, it is to not take life for granted. When you go to high school, appreciate the little moments you have in class. You know, when you have 5 minutes left of class and you, your classmates, and your teacher are talking and joking around, enjoy those moments. Ms. Ramirez and I would give anything to have just 5 more minutes with our 8R and 8S families. With this, I leave you some advice. Be a leader and have confidence. It gets you noticed and gives you opportunities. When you appreciate someone, tell them. We need more positivity in the world. Find a role model to look up to. This could be a family member, family friend, or teacher. If you're lucky, you already have one, but it's never too late. Apologize, but don't just apologize. When you do something wrong, say sorry and then be better. Be truthful even when it would be so easy not to. When it counts, people are going to believe the person who always tells the truth, not the person who only tells the truth when it's convenient for them. And lastly, be who your teachers, families, and friends know you can be. We have high expectations for you because we know you can meet them. Your future is bright. You are going to do so many big things in life, and I can't wait to hear all about them. You have made myself and all of us at St. Adalbert so proud.
During our time at St. Adalbert, we have had many teachers that have shaped us into who we are today. Whether we had them as homeroom teachers or they greeted us with a good morning at the start of every day, they have all been a part of our experience at St. Adalbert. Now they will share some advice and well wishes for the future.
Hi, 8th grade graduates, it's Mr. Sepulis. Many of you started school here at St. Adalbert School the same year I did, believe it or not. Back then, you were kindergartners and I was just starting my first year as a teacher here. Now, as I sit here and look at this class picture of many of you who are in my homeroom just 3 years ago, I wonder where the time went. It makes me emotional and proud to think of how far all of you have come with your learning, your leadership, and maturity. I look forward to, in the years to come, hearing about the many wonderful things that you will have accomplished in high school, college, and beyond. I just want to say thank you for helping me become a better teacher than I was in the beginning, and I wish all of you the best in the future as you continue to experience life's challenges. Remember, as I used to say in my class when you were here, actions speak louder than words. Be good, be healthy, and God bless. Thank you.
Hello, class of 2020. Congratulations. I just wanted to send a quick congrats. And as Dr. Seuss would say, congratulations. Today is your day. You're off to great places. You're off and away. Have fun. I see a bright future in front of you. Congratulations.
Hi, guys. It's Mrs. M. I wanted to say congratulations on your graduation from St. Adalbert. I'm really excited for you guys to take this next step in your life. It's really an exciting time, and it really goes by fast. So really take advantage of it and go to everything you can and get involved in things at school. It's really kind of sad, hard when you look back and you remember how fast it went. So really take advantage of the time you have in high school. I also just really quickly wanted to thank you for how much you have taught me, which sounds really backwards because I was a teacher, so it's kind of backwards. But the year that you guys were in the fifth grade was my first year at St. Adalbert and my first year as a teacher in general. And I learned so much from having you guys as my fifth grade class that year. And even though we learned a lot of math, I think I learned the most and how to be the best teacher that I can be. So you guys really did that for me. And every time I think of something new to try, I think of you guys and the things that you guys have taught me. So I hope you guys are as excited as we all are for you. And we will miss you. And you always have a home here at St. Adalbert. Bye.
Huge shout out to the class of 2020. All of us at St. Adalbert are so proud of you guys. I know that I can speak for myself and for all the K-4 kids. We're so blessed to have you as our buddies. They all look up to you so much and they love you and they're gonna miss you tons. I just have a little quote that I wanted to share with you guys. Behind you are all of your memories. Before you are all of your dreams. Around you are all those who love you, and within you is all you need. I want you all to know how special you are and how much we all love you and God loves you. And I just cannot express enough how much just be who you are, and God has a plan for every one of you, and life is going to throw you curveballs sometimes, but God knows your path, and just go out and be good humans. We are all rooting for you.
Hi, class of 2020. First of all, congratulations on your graduation. I know that you've worked very, very, very hard to get here, and thank you for making such great music with me. I wish you all the best of luck, and may God bless you in your future academic pursuits and your personal life. And if you're ever feeling down, play music, listen to music, sing music. It always makes me feel better. Bye.
Hi there, it's Miss Galvan here, just stopping by to wish all of our eighth graders best of luck. Congratulations, you've made it through St. Adalbert School. And you're moving on to the next level, and I wish you all of the best. Take care of yourselves, study hard, play hard, and a super special shout out to all the eighth graders in Ms. Smith's class. We had a fun time getting to know each other, even if it was for just a short amount of time, but I really appreciate all of your kindness and love that you showed the little ones, so thank you, thank you, thank you. Have a wonderful summer, and again, congratulations. Take care. Bye-bye.
Hi, eighth graders. I just wanted to say I'm so proud of you for your upcoming graduation. I'm so proud of all the work that you've done and all the growth that you've achieved since I started teaching you in sixth grade. I know that you are all going to go on to do amazing things in high school, and I hope you come back and say hi.
Congratulations, eighth grade graduates. I'm so proud of all your accomplishments. Continue that love of learning into your high school adventure, and good luck next year.
Hello, class of 2020. This is Mrs. Renteria here saying congratulations to you all. I know this is not the graduation you were hoping for and praying for, but I do want to say congratulations, good luck in whatever you are doing next, and remember, come back and visit and let us know what's happening. Congratulations.
Eighth grade 2020. It's Miss Jamie here. If you encounter an obstacle out there in the real world, past the walls of St. Adalbert, and somebody is kicking you down, is telling you you can't do it, if somebody is telling you that you can't do something, it's because they fear you will. So don't ever, ever let anybody tell you you can't do something, because it only means that they fear you will. You know, we know, that you can do anything you set your mind to. Final piece of advice for you all, whatever it is you choose to do in your life, past eighth grade, beyond high school, is no matter what you do, is make sure that it's something you love. Because you'll be able to do your job with a smile on your face like all of us do here at St. Adalbert. So please just make sure it's something that you love and that you're passionate about, and the rest will follow. I promise. I wish you all nothing but the best, and I look forward to seeing your faces next, whenever that is.
Dear 8th graders, congratulations on your special day. This is probably not the kind of graduation you were expecting. I realize it is different, but it is also the same. It is still all about you and your hard work. As you begin the next phase of your life's journey, I want you to remember your time at St. Adalbert. You have a strong foundation that your teachers help you to build. This strong foundation will help you when you have difficult decisions to make, such as, should I or shouldn't I? I want you to think back to your time at St. Adalbert. I think that will help you make the correct choice. I wish you all the best in your future. Please come back and visit. I would love to hear about all that you have been doing. Good luck, guys.
8th grade, congratulations on finally graduating. I am so incredibly proud of you guys. You put in so much hard work, especially during this crazy quarantine pandemic time, and I know your graduation is not ideal. I miss you guys so much, and I can't even tell you how much I want to be there to see you guys walk across the stage. I remember last year when I first came to St. Adalbert, and this class, you guys, you were my first ever class that I ever taught, and you made my love of teaching so much stronger. You guys seriously made me laugh so hard. I have so many funny memories from that year, and I am going to miss you guys so much. I'm going to miss you guys walking down the hall, you guys saying hi to me every morning, and even this year I didn't even teach you guys, but I still had study hall with some of you guys, and that was still so much fun hanging out with you. I wish you guys nothing but the best, and you guys are going to do amazing in your futures. Do not be worried about high school. Don't be worried about seniors in the hallway or anything. You guys will do great, and I can't wait to see where you guys go. Please come by and visit too. Miss you, and congratulations!
Just as our talents and personalities vary, our feelings about moving on from St. Adalbert range in many different directions. The excitement and the nervousness, joy and sadness, anticipation, optimism, and doubt, as well as anxiousness. Although they can't say it all, we, the 8th grade class, would like to present our classmate, Gerald Ramos, to give you some insight.
Hey 8th graders, it's Jeriel. I hope you're all safe, healthy, and following COVID-19 guidelines. I am currently in Florida and won't be back in Wisconsin in time for our virtual graduation service. So I'm going full virtual mode, and I'm so honored to get this opportunity to share this message with you all. For starters, I am really bummed that we cannot go on our exciting trips and celebrate our last year of middle school. It's very unfortunate that most of us will never be in the same classroom again. However, don't let this year be the downer. Instead, look back at all the memories you made as a class before this pandemic. I've been at St. Adalbert School for 10 years now, and I know some of you guys have too. Each year has had its ups and downs, but I can truly say I had so much fun with my friends and teachers every year. Seeing how I grew as a person and how all of you have grown and matured is crazy. Looking back at my time at St. Adalbert, the year that sticks out to me the most was 4th grade, as it was hands down the craziest year. It's crazy to think I went from a little bald K-4 kid to a crazy 8th grader. And for everyone I just met this year or recently, I loved all the memories, and you are no exception to this. Some of you really shaped me as a person and helped me through some difficult times. It's crazy to me we're finally going into high school. And even under these circumstances, I am so grateful for this school year, my teachers, and all of you. As we go into high school, I want you guys to always remember how smart, creative, amazing, talented, kind, passionate, worthy you are. Make sure you put all your effort into your academics and extracurriculars. Remember to be the best you that you could be. If you are ever going through a tough time in high school or even during the summer, don't hesitate to reach out to me. Lastly, I wanted to leave you all with my favorite Bible verse that always keeps my head up. Isaiah chapter 43, verse 2. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you. And when you pass through the rivers, they will not sweep over you. When you walk through the fire, you will not be burned. The flames will not set you ablaze. This verse keeps me grounded because it's just a reminder that no matter what you go through, God is always right there by your side. He will never, ever let anything bad happen to you. He loves you more than anyone, anyone. Have an amazing summer. Miss you all. And don't let future people change who you are and who you want to be. And now before I end this video, I want to give a special shout out to Stacy and Jaxie. You two came into my life the exact moment I needed you both. You guys helped me through some very dark and difficult times in my life. You guys gave me a voice when I was voiceless, and you helped me felt accepted when I felt like an outcast. I love you both, and I hope you guys have an amazing high school, and it goes to the rest of you too. Bye!
Each of our middle school teachers will have a chance to recognize outstanding students from their classroom this school year. The students were chosen by teachers based on academic improvement or academic achievement, any subject area. We will start our award with our middle school science teacher, Ms. Leitner.
The Science Academic Award is given to students who show a great amount of growth in the areas of science, experimentation, and teamwork. This year, I'm very happy to announce that the winners of those awards are Alejandra Anderson and Daniel Torres Roman.
Hello, 8th grade. This is Ms. Renteria here to present our two awards for English Language Arts. For high achievement, always using time wisely and producing high quality work, our student receiving the award from 8S is Wendy Morales Ibarra. And from 8R is Adrian Ortiz Zamora. Congratulations, students. Very proud of you.
This year's Social Studies Award goes to two students who have shown so much growth over the past year in Social Studies. These students always put their best foot forward in class, show dedication to their learning, and are constantly striving to show growth, even during online learning. Congratulations, Alondra Ventura and Daniela Perez.
This year, I'm giving the Math Award to two students who have grown immensely over this past year. These students perform exceptionally in class, worked hard during online learning, have a positive attitude, and are model students. This year, the Math Award goes to Crystal Navarro and Michelle Garcia.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Albert, Dean of Instruction. I am here today to award this year's Overall Academic Achievement Award. This award goes to the student that has had the highest GPA throughout their career here at St. Adalbert. This year's recipient is Stacy Ramirez Alanis.
Hi, Mrs. Manier here, Dean of Students. I am really excited to announce this year's Eagle Award winner. This award was first created last year as an award to really make sure that we're recognizing a student that embodies the spirit of St. Adalbert. This student that is awarded this Eagle Spirit Award not only is a great performer in the classroom, but someone that really makes everyone feel included and has a really strong school spirit. I'm really pleased to announce that this year's winner is Jeriel Ramos.
Greetings, graduates. I would like to welcome all of our families, friends, teachers, and staff to this wonderful occasion. To have you all here, although virtual, is truly a testament to the love and support that all of our extraordinary young people have in their lives. To the parents and caretakers of our graduates, thank you. Thank you for being our partners and fulfilling your commitment to your children's education, rooted not just in academics, but in faith in the name of Jesus Christ. I would also like to thank Mrs. Meniere, Ms. Ramirez, Ms. Smith, Mrs. Leitner, Mr. Newval, and Ms. Jamie, along with our other amazing faculty and staff members, for their work to provide a wonderful and unique graduation experience for our students. I would also like to thank Father Mauricio for celebrating with us and for being a spiritual and professional leader in our school and community. Thank you to Ms. Lydia Botello and Mrs. Lydia Bonilla for lending their time and talents in filming this special event. It has been my pleasure getting to know each and every one of our graduates these past 2 years. I am happy to say that you have made me very proud of the young men and women you have become over the course of the past 2 years. You have risen to the challenges that have come to pass this year by applying two very important skills. These are the skills of adapting to change and persevering to overcome obstacles. Many of you finished this year not just as students, but as caretakers at home, teachers to your siblings, and strong members of support for your families during this unprecedented time. We are proud of the work you were able to accomplish in order to be prepared for high school. Let the experience of these past couple months be a reminder to all of you that you are strong, you are competent, and you are special. Take your experiences and the lessons you have learned to help build a better world. A world of justice, kindness, respect, love, and faith. The end of this journey, however, only means the beginning of another. Never forget your roots, but also know that your roots do not define who you will be. You will define who you will be. Your time is limited, so don't waste it by living someone else's life or fulfilling someone else's dreams. Don't let the noise of other people's opinions drown out your own powerful ideas and voices. And most importantly, have the courage to follow your heart and intuition. All of you hold a very special place in the heart of this school, so I ask that you carry with you the lessons, the love, and the hope that we know you will be good Catholics, good students, and most important of all, great people. Many people wish you luck as you move on from St. Adalbert to high school or from high school to college. But what most of us know, however, is that very little in life comes from luck. The best things in life come from faith, hard work, determination, and perseverance. So as you move forward, instead of wishing you luck today, I wish you all faith, hard work, determination, and perseverance as you continue your journey in life. God bless all of you, and congratulations, class of 2020.
Saludos graduandos. Me gustaría dar la bienvenida a todas las familias, amigos, maestros y personal a esta maravillosa ocasión. Tenerlos a todos aquí, aunque virtuales, es realmente un testimonio del amor y el apoyo que todos nuestros jóvenes extraordinarios tienen en sus vidas. A los padres y cuidadores de nuestros alumnos, gracias. Gracias por ser nuestros socios y cumplir sus compromisos con la educación de sus hijos, arraigados no solo en lo académico, sino también en la fe y en el nombre de Jesucristo. También me gustaría agradecer a la Mrs. Meniere, a Ms. Ramirez, a Ms. Smith, a Mrs. Leitner, a Mr. Nuval, y a Ms. Jamie, junto con nuestros otros docentes y miembros del personal increíbles por su trabajo para proporcionar una experiencia de graduación maravillosa y única para los estudiantes. También me gustaría agradecer al Padre Mauricio por celebrar con nosotros y por ser un líder espiritual y profesional para nuestra escuela. Gracias a Ms. Lydia Botello y Ms. Lydia Bonilla por prestar su tiempo y talento para filmar este evento especial. Fue un placer para mí conocerlos a todos y cada uno de ustedes en los últimos 2 años. Me alegra decir que me han hecho sentir muy orgulloso de los hombres y mujeres jóvenes en los que se han convertido en el transcurso de este año. Han superado los desafíos que se han presentado este año aplicando 2 habilidades muy importantes. Estas son las habilidades de adaptarse al cambio y perseverar para superar los obstáculos. Muchos de ustedes terminaron este año no solo como estudiantes, sino como cuidadores en el hogar, maestros de sus hermanos y miembros fuertes de apoyo a sus familias durante este tiempo sin precedentes. Estamos orgullosos del trabajo que pudieron realizar para estar preparados para la escuela superior. Permitan que la experiencia de estos últimos 2 meses les recuerde a todos que son fuertes, que son competentes y que son especiales. Tomen sus experiencias y las lecciones que han aprendido para ayudar a construir un mundo mejor, un mundo de justicia, amabilidad, respeto, amor y fe. El final de este viaje, sin embargo, solo significa el comienzo de otro. Nunca olvides tus raíces, pero también debes saber que tus raíces no definen quién serás. Tú defines quién serás. Su tiempo es limitado, así que no lo desperdicien viviendo la vida de otra persona o cumpliendo los sueños de otra persona. No permitan que el ruido de las opiniones de otras personas ahoguen sus propias ideas y voces poderosas. Y lo más importante, tengan el coraje de seguir su corazón e intuición. Todos ustedes tienen un lugar especial en el corazón de esta escuela, así que le pido que lleven con ustedes las lecciones, el amor y la esperanza de que sabemos que serán buenos católicos, buenos estudiantes y, lo más importante de todo, excelentes personas. Muchas personas les desearán suerte cuando se vayan de San Alberto a la escuela superior o de la escuela superior a la universidad. Lo que la mayoría de nosotros sabemos, sin embargo, es que poco en la vida proviene de la suerte. Las mejores cosas de la vida provienen de la fe, el trabajo duro, la determinación y la perseverancia. Entonces, a medida que avanzan, en lugar de desearles suerte hoy, les deseo fe, trabajo duro, determinación y perseverancia a medida que continúan sus viajes de vida. Dios los bendiga a todos y felicidades a la clase de 2020.
Kenya Aguilera. Omar Altamirano Noriega. Alejandra Anderson. Samantha Arce Escobar. Diego Salis. Justin Salis. Elizabeth Chavez. Jose Chavez Mora. Nancy Cornejo Solorio. Michelle Garcia Marin. Ashley Isidoro. Nikki Lopez Mayorga. Davy Lozada. Miriam Medina Danielle. Jaxi Morales Ayala. Wendy Morales Ibarra. Uriel Munoz Guerrero. Edith Morales Rivas. Jasmine Nunez Romero. Israel Olalde Jalpa. Daniela Perez. Carlos Placencia Flores. Stacy Ramirez Alanis. Jeriel Ramos. Nadia Roblero Alvarado. Yesenia Robles Solot. Kevin Solano Serna. Myra Vega Miramontes. Diego Aguilar. Jeslaine Contreras. Saul Dominguez Macera. Manuel Eugenio Juan. Brian Gonzalez Rosales. Sandra Hernandez. Diana Herrera Hurtado. Cindy Isidoro Sanchez. Margaret Lara Villanueva. Rosario Madrigal Ortega. Tabitha Martinez Avila. Naomi Martinez Ibarra. Vianne Montiel Lopez. Crystal Navarro Briseño. Harumi Nolasco Fernandez. Adrian Ortiz Zamora. Gustavo Renteria Ubarrio. Jacqueline Reyes Castillo. Mariana Rivas. Ruby Ruiz Erejon. Juan Serna. Oscar Silvestre Tejeda. Antonio Soto. Daniel Torres Roman. Yesenia Velasco Reyna. Alondra Ventura Gonzalez. Evelyn Zuniga Herrera.
We would like to acknowledge your families. Thank you for believing in us, even when we didn't believe in ourselves. We could not be here today without your love and support. May this be a small thank you to the many years you have committed to us and our education.
Nos gustaría agradecer a nuestras familias. Gracias por creer en nosotros, incluso cuando no creíamos en nosotros mismos. No podríamos estar aquí hoy sin su amor y apoyo. Que esto sea un pequeño agradecimiento a los muchos años que nos han comprometido a nosotros y a nuestra educación.
We would now like to thank the families of the graduates who no longer will have students here at St. Adalbert after this ceremony. With the conclusion of your students' time here at St. Adalbert, you are finished with your time as a parent here at St. Adalbert. We thank you for all that you have added to our school, and remember, you're always part of our family and community.
Ahora queremos agradecer a las familias de los graduados que ya no tendrán estudiantes aquí en San Adalberto después de esta ceremonia. Con la conclusión del tiempo de su estudiante aquí en San Adalberto, ha terminado su tiempo como padre aquí en San Adalberto. Le agradecemos todo lo que ha hecho y todo lo que ha agregado a nuestra escuela. Y recuerde que siempre es parte de nuestra familia y comunidad.
Everything that we don't want to find, it'll be just you and me.
Our class will not perform one last time together. We will sing in this their version of Hallelujah, a song we worked hard to learn in music class this year. This song will focus on remembering to rejoice and continue to praise God as we journey into high school.
A crown of thorns placed on his head. He knew that he would soon be dead. He said, "Did you forget me, Father, did you?" They nailed him to a wooden cross. Soon all the world would feel the loss of Christ the King before us. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
He hung his head and prepared to die, then lifted his face up to the sky, said, "I am coming home now, Father, to you." A reed which held his final sip was gently lifted to his lips. He drank his last and gave his soul to glory.
The soldier who had used his sword to pierce the body of our Lord said, "Truly, this is Jesus Christ, our Savior." He looked with fear upon his sword, then turned to face his Christ and Lord, fell to his knees, crying.
Risen,
hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Como la celebración llega a su fin, recordemos que todo es posible con Dios. Él nos fortalece y nos levanta. Como dice Isaías 40:29-31, Él da esfuerzo al cansado y multiplica las fuerzas al que no tiene ningunas. Los muchachos se fatigan y se cansan. Los jóvenes flaquean y caen. Pero los que esperan a Dios tendrán nuevas fuerzas, levantarán alas como las águilas, correrán y no se cansarán, caminarán y no se fatigarán.